Okay, then we will calculate this one. And we have known that PA is 1 divided 3, and PB is 1 divided 2. Then I ask you calculate this one. Okay. Here we have two cases. One case is that A is a subset of B. All right?
Yes.
So here, if A is this is case one. Case one, A is a subset of B, all right? All right. Then here, the intersections of B and the complement of A. You see, B intersection complement of A is in fact B intersection the complement of A is this area, right?
Yes.
This area, in fact, is equal to B difference A. All right. Be different A. So you see that if A is a subset of B, then P B A complement of A is P B minus A. Alright? And A is a subset of B. So this probability is equal to P B minus P A, right?
Yes.
Right? So we put this value in it. This is a okay, you can easily calculate this 1 divided 6. Alright? Okay, this is case 1, that A is a subset of B. Alright? And the second is that if intersections of A and B is 1 divided 8, alright, then ask you calculate TB intersection A. So here, this one, this case we are not considered. So we can draw the second case. This is A. This is B. Alright? This is general case, alright? This is a special case, alright? So here how to calculate the second case. So here we say that intersections of A and B.
Yeah.
Alright?
Yes.
Alright?
Yeah.
So here you see the probability. This is a subset of B. Alright? So we can use the probability 3. Alright? This is equal to PB minus PAB. Alright? Then we put this value in it. So we can easily calculate this is 3 divided 8. Alright? Okay. Okay, for the next part, we will introduce you two random trails we usually encounter. Okay? Next, we will show you two types of random trail. Two types of random trail. The first type we call it the classic probability model. Classic probability model. Although it means it's a model, but it is not a model, but it stands for a type of trail, a type of random trail. Okay, so don't make confusion. Okay, this is a classic probability model. It stands for one type of random trail. one type of reading trigger. Okay, we can see the definition. Let E be a reading trigger. If it sample space, if it sample space Lambda consists of a finite number of possible outcomes, that is to say, there is only finite outcomes, and the probabilities of every outcome is the same. The probability of every outcome is the same. Then we call the trail as a classic probability model. Okay? Here, if the sample space consists of finite numbers of possible outcomes, then the probability loss is specified by the probabilities of event that consists of a single element. In particular, the probability of any event is the sum of the probability of each element. So here, we have defined a classic probability model. So, how to understand this model? That is to say, the sample space, the numbers of the sample space is finite. It's finite. Okay? So we can assure the sample space consists as omega 1, omega 2, omega n. Okay? That's to say omega has the element of n. N is finite, alright? So the sample space is finite. Okay? The sample space is finite, it means that the element in sample space is finite. Okay, so we can assure that the number of an element in sample space is n. Is n, okay?
Yes.
Okay, this is in order for you to understand it clearly. So we said there has n element. Okay, this is the first condition. And the second is that the probability of omega 1 is equal to omega 2 and p omega n. Alright? That to say that every outcome is the same. The probabilities of the every outcome is the same. Okay? Okay. For example, when you throw a dice, this is the dice, alright? Alright? And every side has a point, alright? From 1 to 6. Alright, so the sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright? Alright?
Yes.
And the probabilities of every outcome is
the same.
The curse of point 1. Is equal to 2, alright? Alright? Is what? Here we also consider the possibility of point 1 is equal to the probabilities of equal point 2. Alright? 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 So we think every point appear the possibility of every point appear is the same. All right. So for the throw a dice, For the experiment of showing the dice, we can say this is a classic probability model. Alright, since the sample space has finite element, alright, and every outcome has the same probability, alright. So this one can be say a classic probability model. Also, if you for coin tosses, this experiment can be also say as a classic probability model. Alright, since sample space is H and T, and the probabilities of appearance of H is the same as the probabilities of appearance of tail. Alright, so coefficients can be also see a classic probability model. Okay? Okay, here, in order to coincide with RPPT, I will give some change for sample point. We can use this S1, S2, and SN. Okay, this is S1, S2, SN. Okay. So you see that this set is a union of this set and this set and this set, alright, and all these sets are disjoint, alright. So by the properties of two, by the additive property, alright. So here this probability is equal to this sum. Alright, 5.2. Additive, finite additive property. Alright, finite additive. So this one is equal to this one. Right, and the units of them is the sample space. Alright, alright. And for sample space, the probability is 1. Alright. Okay. So here we have know that all this probability is equal, alright? Alright? So if we denote this as A, if we denote this probability as A, alright? Yeah. If we denote this as A, then here this is A. Alright? This is A. Alright? This is A. Alright? So the sum we are equal to
and
A. Alright? So from this inequality, this sum is 1. Then we can induce that A is 1 divided A. Alright? Yeah. Just to say, for classical probability model, if the element is A, alright, then for every basic event, basically, then this the probability is 1 divided A. Okay? Yeah, this is to say the probabilities of the basic event, then the probability is 1 divided the length of the sample space. Okay? Okay. So, the first result is that this one. Right. Okay. Next, we will show you that in this models for any event A, how to calculate the probabilities of the event A. Okay. So, the result is that the probabilities of event A is equal to the numbers of the element of A. Divide the numbers of sample space, right? Divide A. Okay. So this one is very easy. Similarly, we put this as A, all right? Then, okay, here we have said in here, all right? This is the first one I'm going to show you in here, all right? Here we prove this one. Assure that A consists of K element, all right? So we denote this K element as Si1, Si2, Sik. Okay?
Yes.
So by the finite identity of probability, we have this one. Pa is equal to this one, right? Is there any question? Since this is A, right? All right. And this set is the union of this set, and this set, all right? And all these sets are destroyed. Alright? So by the finite additivity, so we have this probability, alright, is equal to the sum of this probability. Okay, here. Okay? This is PA, alright? So here we have said that for any basic event, the probability is A, alright? So here, this one is A, this one is A, this is A, all right? So we have the sum of Ka, all right? So here, this is the sum. This one is K multiply A, all right? This is K10, all right? Everything is A, all right? All right?
Yes.
And we have shown that A is equal to 1 divided n. Right? So this one we have obtained k divided n. Okay. Then k can be seen as the numbers of the element of A. Alright? And divide n. Okay. So for class probability models, we have shown that the probabilities of an event is equal to the numbers of the element of A divided the total numbers of sample space. Right? So here you can see this element of sample space. Numbers. Numbers of element of sample space, right? Okay. Okay. Here is an example. The example is that consider the experiment of rolling a pair of four-sided dice. Can you imagine the four sides of dice? The shape of four sided dice? Can you imagine? Four sided dice? Can you imagine the shape of four sided dice? Dice. Can you imagine?
No.
Okay, here you can see like this. What is this? How do you spell it?
Prison.
Can you write it? Can you help me? Can you help me write it? Okay. Who can write the English then on this shape? Can you help me?
No.
They know this shape. This geometric.
Land.
What is land?
No, I think it's a rhombus.
People from the country speaking is this.
Oh. Okay, what is? What is? Can you spell it in English?
No.
We study the advanced mathematics. The teacher must introduce this geometric. What is? The Chinese name I know. The Chinese name we know. But you all need to know this shape, this one has four sides, all right? And every side we can give a point on it, all right? So this one here we give one, this one we give two, this one we give three, and this one we give four, all right? It has four sides, all right? All right? It has four sides. Alright, so you can see this as four side dice, alright?
This one, right?
Yeah. Four side dice, alright?
What can I got?
Since you know, this is the six side dice, alright?
This one, yeah.
Alright? Yes. And this can be seen as four side of dice. Yeah. Okay, then when you saw this guy's on the ground, then there is only one side touch on the ground.
Yeah.
All right? Mm-hmm. Then the point touch on the side as the outcome will depend. Okay? Then you say if the side 4 touching the ground, then we consider the outcome is 4. Okay? Okay? Is there any question? Doesn't you say if the side four touch you on the ground, then we say the experiment of the outcome is 4.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So you can see this as a four side dice. Alright. Alright?
Yeah.
Okay, then we saw this dice for two times, a pair of four side dice. You can see it as you saw the dice for two times.
Yeah.
Or two dice so at the same time. Okay. We are sure the dice are fair. And we interpret this assumption to mean that each of the 16 possible outcomes has the same probability of 1 divided 16. Right? So, here we can use order pair ij. Order pair ij. This is order pair we have introduced last week, yesterday, right? This is the order pair, right? I stand for the side of the point of the first story. Okay? J stands for the point, the second time you are showing. Right? Okay, so here is I and J. So, how many cases will appear in this experiment? So here, maybe I take value 1, right? And J take value 1. This is This is the first outcome, right? And we also have 1, 2. All right, that's to say the first throwing is 0.1 and the second throwing is 0.2. All right? And so on. This is 1, 4. All right? And the first outcome may be 2. All right? The second may be 1.
2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4.
All right, and so on. This is 4, 1.
4, 2, 4, 4.
How many cases? This is 4 multiplied 4.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
So this is the sample space. All right.
Yes.
When you throw in a pair of both sides of dice, all the possible outcome is here, right?
Yeah.
All right. This is all the possible outcome of throwing two dice.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. And here we give the substitute that. The dice are fair. The dice are fair, that is to say, the probability of appear 0.1 is equal to the probability of appear 0.2 and so on. Okay. So here, we can need to say the length of sample space is 16. Alright? So here, that is to say, we have this. So this is a 16 possible outcome, right? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so much. And each of the possible outcome has a probability of 1 divided 16, right? Right? Here? This is the possible outcome, right? Alright, is 1 divided the length of the sample space. Alright, here n take value 16. Okay, so the problem is that to calculate the probability of event, we must count the length of element of event and divide by 16, right?
Yes.
The problem is we have this problem. The first is that the event is the sum of the rows is even. The sum of the rows is even. Okay. The first one ask you to calculate this one. Okay, so we can say this one, the sum of the row is even. Right? Ask you to calculate the probability. Okay, the sum of them is even. Here we can see this line, this vertex line as the rows of the poster throwing. The point of poster throwing, this is 1. 2, 3, 4. I take a value 1, 2, 3, 4, right? J also take a value 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Alright? So if you want the sum of the throwing is even, alright? Then here in this picture, if you want the sum of the rows is even, then here if this is J, alright? If I take a value 1 and the sum of them is even, then the J must take a value 1. Right? So this point is okay. 1 and 1 is 2. 2 is even. Alright? And here this one, this is, it stands for I take a value 2. Alright? And the J?
1.
J1. This point is not. It's not right, alright. This will be the sum of the rows is even. Alright? And here, this one is okay, right? And this one is okay. This is I take value 3 and J take value 1. Right? And this one.
Of course.
And this one.
That's one.
Alright? And this one. And this one. And this one. Alright? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright? So in this event, the element of the has the labels of the element of the is 8. Alright? Alright? This set has 8 elements. Alright, so this probability is 8 divided 16, the 1 divided 2. Okay, here if you want to calculate the event of the sum of the rows in order, it is easy to see. Alright, this one such this condition, this one. Alright, so it is easy to say that it is also 1 divided. Alright?
Sorry.
1 divided 2. Okay. Okay, here you can also say if this you can set this this set as A. And this set is the complement of A, right? Alright? The sum is order, the complement is the sum is even. Alright, so you can also use this probability is 1 divided PA. Right? It's also 1 divided 2. Okay? Okay, I will take this away. Okay, the third question is that the first row is equal to the second row. The first row is equal to the second row, so this point. I take value 1, take value 1.
1.
This point.
3.
Alright. This way, alright. And for 4. Alright. So this is 4 divided 16. Okay. Then the first row is larger than the second row. The first row is larger than the second row. So here you see this one. The first is 1, second is 2. Alright? And this one. And this one. Alright? This one, I take value 3. J take value 4. Alright? So only this 3 point. Alright?
No,
yes.
And this one.
Alright? Yes. So here, the probability is 6 divided 16. Right? Okay. Here, at least one row is equal to 4. Equal to 4, that is to say, at least one row. At least one row. So here, this point, alright? The second row is 4, alright? And here, this point, alright? The first row is 4, alright? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright? So, okay?
Okay,
do you know how to calculate the probability of the event?
Yes.
You first know the labels of same space, alright? And the second, you must to know the labels of the element of the event A. Alright? Then we divide the end. Okay? Okay. Next, we will introduce you another type of reading tree. This reading tree we call it a geometric probability model. The definition can be like this: let E be a reading tree if it has the following property. The first one is that the sample space is a geometric area. And the area can be measured. We denote the measure of the same space by Mn logica. Such the measure. Here the measure we can see as length, area, and volume. Okay? This is the measure. If I give you a knife, then you can measure this knife can be measured, right? Yeah, this measure can be seen as length. Right? Right? If I give you a circle, then the measure is area. Right? Okay. So for the same space we use the measure of we use the Mn logica for the measure. Okay. This is the first property. The second property is that if we throw a point to the area, the possibility of the point length of any point of area is equal. Let you say if we throw a chocolate to this area, then the chocolate hit this point is the same of the chocolate to shoot this one. It's the same, right? We shoot the possibility of shoot this one is the same as shoot this one. Okay, chocolate. Right? So chocolate hit this one. It's the same as the chocolate hit this one. Right? Fuck. Sorry. I remember. Fuck. Okay. Here you can also see the element in the same space is infinite. Okay. Then here you can see that for every outcome the probability is zero. This is different from the classic classic probability model. Okay, I will show you. If A is the area, if A denotes the area the point may throw in. Okay, here, if this is the same space, okay? This is A. Okay. If I denote the area the point may be thrown in, then the probability of the event A is equal to the measures of A divided the measures of same space. Okay, this formula shows you how to calculate the probabilities of event A in geometrical probability model. Okay. You just need to use MA divide M same space. Okay? So here you can see here, if this is a same space, alright, then the probability if you shoot this area, alright? Okay. Then you can calculate the probability of the truck hit this area, right? Alright. So you can calculate the probability is area of A, right? Divide area of same space. Alright. This is the possibility that the truck hit in this area. Okay? Okay. Next, I will give you an example. This example can be seen as problems of dating. And then the possibility of the success of dating. Okay. You have a dating? For someone?
Yes.
Okay, here we see this example. Romeo and Juliet have a date. Okay, and each of them will arrive between time 12 o'clock and 13 o'clock. Okay, so here in picture, zero stands for 12 o'clock, and one divide 13 o'clock. Okay.
Yes.
So here, and X can be stand for the time. Yes, Romeo arrived. And Y stands for the time that Juliet arrived. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, so here, this is 12 o'clock. Here is 13 o'clock, alright? Okay, we use 0 to stand for 12. And 1 divide 13. Alright? So in your clock, right? In your clock, then 0. Maybe 0 stands for 12 o'clock, 1 stands for 13, right? Okay, so here, in picture, we can use 0 stands for 12, 1 stands for 13, okay. And here is a condition. The first to arrive will wait for 15 minutes and will leave if the other has not yet arrived. Okay, that you see. The girl will wait the boy for 15 minutes,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And also, the boys will only wait the girls for 15 minutes, all right? This is impossible. maybe the boys will wait for more time for the girls.
Yeah.
3 hours.
All right? 3 hours.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay. So, here the problem is that what is the probability that they will date successfully? Okay, so here, how do we solve this problem? We let X and Y be the arrival time of Romeo and Juliet. Okay, so all the possible arrival time of their arrival time, we can use order pair XY. Right, and x, y maybe take a value in this area, right?
Yeah.
Okay, this symbol stands for, here we use multiply, right? This symbol stands for this area, okay? So, the simple space is this area, right?
Yeah.
This simple space. Since Romeo and Juliet can be arrived at any time of interval from 0 to 1, right? So the possibility of arrival x and y at any point of same space is the same. Alright? That is to say, then both of them may be arrived at this time. Alright? And maybe this time. Alright? The possibility we consider as the same. Okay, so this trio can be seen as a geometric probability model. All right. Since same space has infinite element. All right, infinite element, and if you solve a point in this area, then the possibility of getting this one is the same as this one. And this one, right?
Yes.
All right. So this model, this trio can be seen as a geometric probability model. Okay? Alright?
Geometric.
So we can use this formula to calculate the probability. Alright? Okay, so here, let A be the event that dating successfully. Alright? So if they date successfully, then A can be expressed as the following. A can be the area. All right. we can use X and Y to write, right? Right? If they want dating successfully, then X minus Y must less than equal to 1 divided 4. Alright? Alright?
Yes.
1 divided 4 is, we can say, as 15. Alright? Wait for 15 minutes. Alright, we use hour to stand for 15 minutes is 1 divided 4 hours. Alright, here it stands for hours. Alright? This is 1 hour, alright? Okay, so here we use hours to stand for the condition of them dating successfully. Okay, so if they date successfully, then X and Y must satisfy this condition. Alright? So in picture, we only need to find X and Y satisfy this condition. Alright? So here, this area we can say it as this shaded area. Okay, this is we can say this as A. You can easily draw this area. This area stands for Juliet and Romeo dating successfully. Okay. How to calculate this area? Do you know? Since any point of the end satisfy this condition. Okay, so here you can easily to draw this picture. Here you can see that x the opportunity of x minus y less than equal to 1 divided 4, right?
Yes.
Then so here you can write that 1 divided 4 x minus y. Right?
Yes.
So you only need to draw the two border line, right?
Yeah.
Border line is equal to x minus 1. This is the first border line, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the second border line is x minus 1 equal to 1 divided 4, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the second line, right? Second line is, so here you can write it y is equal to x minus 1 divided 4. Right, so this one is equal to y x minus 1, y x and 1 divided 4, right? So here, this line is y equal to x and 1 divided 4, right, so this line. This knot. Okay, and this knot, and this black knot is y equal to x minus 1 divided 4. Okay, so here, this area is between these two knots. This we must less than equal to 1 divided 4. Okay, so here, the event A is this area. Okay, so we use the formula that the probabilities of A is equal to the matrix of A divided the matrix of same space. Here, the matrix is area, alright? Since we can only calculate this area, right? So here is, you can use it to calculate. Do you know how to calculate? No? How to calculate it? So here you see the length of there is right? The length of here is also 1 divided 4, right? So the area of there, this one is equal to this one, right?
Yes.
Right. So here, this shaded area is 1 divided 1 divided 1 is 9. 2, right? Right? This is the angle. Right? This is triangle, right? So here, so 1 divided 2. This is the length and this is wide, right? And here, 2 triangle, right? 2 triangle, right? So you can calculate this is 7 divided 16, right? This is 1. This is the 1 is the measure of same space, right? This is 1 divided 1. 1 multiplied 1, right? So you can easily calculate this in 7 divided 16. Okay. Is there any question? Is there any question?
No.
Okay. We will give you a result. Result one is that an event with probability zero may be not an empty set. An event with probability one, with probability zero, may be not an empty set. Okay, we know that if the event is empty set, then we can deduce the probability of A is zero, right?
Yeah.
Right? But the converse is wrong. Converse is that if A is zero, then we deduce A is empty set. This is wrong. This is wrong. Okay? I will give you an empty example.
Alright.
Okay? So here, we can also see the dating problem. We can also, dating problem, we brought dating problem can give an empty example. So here you see, this now. This line stands for the event. This line stands for what? This line stands for Romeo and Juliet arrive at the same time. Alright, so here, if we denote this as B, then B stands for XY. X equal to Y, right? All right. Okay. The probability of B. But this is equal to the area of B divided the area of same space. All right. Right? Okay. The areas of 9. Area of a 9 is 0. Area of a 9 is 0. Alright?
Yes.
How to prove it? So here is a 9, right? Then we can exchange, enlarge them. We can use this to shade them. Shade them now, right? So here, we can see the length is 8. Let me show you the length is 8. Alright, so here the area, this is a line. This is a line. All right, we denote as L. L. Okay, so the area of L is less than area of this shape. All right. Okay, this shape we can denote as S one. Okay. This one. So the area of L is less than area of this one. All right. Then here, this chain we can depress this chain. Okay. We depress this chain. So the line will become smaller. Right. All right. So here, we can also draw this line, and here the wider become 2h. Alright? Become 2h. The wider become 2h. Alright? Okay, so here the area less than area, this can this S2. The area over here is 2, right? Okay. Here is S2. S2 is equal to, this is wider. This is wider, all right? And the length we can denote as, A. The length of L we denote by A. This is a line, right?
Yes.
The line is L, right?
Yeah.
The length of L we can denote as A. Okay, here. Okay. This is A.
Okay.
So here we can write this area as S Y is A multiply H. Right?
Yes.
Right? Here is A multiply H divided 2. Alright? And then we also depress this geometric. Alright? Okay? Here this picture become this one. Become this one. And this wider become 4H. Okay, I'm going to draw it. Okay. Okay. And so we depress this one. And we can let the this of them become power of 2. H divided power of n power of 2, right?
Yeah.
Alright, so here we can easily to say the area of L. So here, the area of L. Area of L is less than area of, okay, we can now say this as Sn. Sn, okay? Sn. Sn, the area of Sn is equal to A divided H divided 2n, right? Right? And then we continue to depress this geometric, this triangle, this angle, okay? Depress this angle. And then it means that we let n tend to infinity, right? If n tend to infinity, then this one tend to zero. This tend to zero.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Which stands for that for now the area of a line is zero. Right? We take a limit for both of them. Right? Okay. So here you see that for event B, the probability is zero. Alright?
Yes.
But the event B is not an empty set.
Yes.
Alright?
Yes.
It's not an empty set, alright?
Yes.
Is there any question?
No.
Okay. If you have any, question, we can discuss. Ask after the class. Okay. Yes. Okay. So, there you must know. That's for life. The area is narrow. Okay, you must know remember this okay. Here we also have result 2. But even when the probability 1 may be not a sample space. We know for sample space the probability is 1. Alright? Okay, but if there is a set A, the probability is 1. We doesn't deduce that A is a sample space. This is wrong. This is wrong. So we can also use this example. When let's say is equal to sample space difference B. B is here, right?
Yeah.
Right? Then the probability of say is equal to P sample space minus DB. Since B is a subset of sample space, alright? Right? So this is 1. Alright? So we said B is this set and the probabilities of PC is 1. But C is not a sample space. Why? C stands for what? B stands for Juliet and Romeo arrive at the same time, right?
Yes.
This is B. Alright?
Yes, Laoshi.
C stands for what?
Juliet and Romeo
not alive.
Yes. C stands for Juliet and Romeo. Doesn't arrive at the same time. Alright? Alright? So here, this event has probability 1, but this event is not a sample space. Alright? So, please remember these 2 results. Okay. Many students suddenly know this result. Okay. So if you remember Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah.